Now the method of spleen palpation, there are three methods of spleen palpation. One is from the umbilicus towards the left costal margin in this oblique direction, because spleen enlarges obliquely towards the umbilicus. So with each inspiration we will try to palpate for the spleen tip. Now the second method is a bimanual palpation. In bimanual palpation, what we do, we will pull the skin with one hand and will try to palpate the spleen below the costal margin, so that our fingers can easily go below the costal margin to palpate the spleen. Like this, this is a bimanual palpation. Third method of spleen palpation is the method of Middleton maneuver or hooking method, in which the examiner stand on the left side of the patient and patient is turned on the right lateral position like this, and examiner will try to feel for the spleen tip by hooking method, by putting the finger in a curved manner below the left inferior costal margin, and with each inspiration examiner will try to feel for the spleen tip like this. This is a Middleton maneuver or known as the hooking method. The examination of spleen percussion, there are three methods of spleen percussion. First is the Cassell's method of spleen percussion. In this, what we will do, we will take the anterior axillary line. This is anterior axillary line. We will mark it. Now, we will percuss from above downward. So for the percussion, say this is the sternal angle, second intercostal space, third intercostal space, fourth, fifth, like this we will trace. So when we percuss from above below, we will hear the resonant sound of lungs, and the spleen dullness will be percussed at the most ninth intercostal space in the anterior axillary line. So this is the maximum limit of the lung resonance, below which there is a spleen dullness. So suppose if the spleen is enlarged, spleen enlarged in the above direction as well as in the below direction. So if there is a dullness at the ninth intercostal space, that means ki spleen is enlarged. So this is the first method, that is a Cassell's method of spleen percussion. Second method of spleen percussion is the percussion of Tropsch space. That method is known as the Barkan's method. So first we will do the surface marking of a Tropsch space. It is bounded superiorly by the sixth rib. Then the inferior margin is by the costal margin here like this, and the lateral margin is by the mid axillary line. So this I will mark as the Tropsch space. Now if I will percuss in this Tropsch space, there is a tympanic sound due to the stomach fundus, which is mostly empty or contain the air. Now if there is a dullness to percussion, that means ki spleen is enlarged. This method of spleen percussion is known as the Barkan's method of spleen percussion. Third method of spleen percussion is the Nixon's method of spleen percussion, in which we will do the surface marking of posterior axillary line. This is posterior axillary line, and the second line that we will take is the costal margin. This is the costal margin like this. Now, this percussion starts from the above downward. So, when we are doing the percussion, there is a lung resonance. And when the spleen dullness comes, we will then percuss on a perpendicular line from the midpoint of this costal margin towards the posterior axillary line, like this. Now, this is the line of the spleen. If we will do the percussion on this perpendicular line, and this percussion should start from the last point of the lung resonance, and then it will turn towards the mid portion of the inferior costal margin, and this percussion will show us dullness of spleen. And normally this dullness of the spleen is 6 to 8 centimeters. Now if the this line is more than 8 centimeter dullness, that means spleen is enlarged. This is a Nixon method of the spleen percussion.